So welcome to the course of basic electronics. Today this is the second lecture for the topic of digital electronics. In previous class I reviewed the concept of binary number system and hexadecimal that decimal number system. In today's class we shall talk about the binary number hexadecimal number system and the octal number system. Okay, and after discussing these two remaining number systems, we shall go to the concept of complements. Okay, so let me tell you what this hexadecimal number system is. Just like you saw in the case of binary number system, there we had two possible digits for each position, 1 and 0. In hexadecimal number system, we have total 16 possible numbers which can be assigned at a particular position. Okay, and these numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, just like the decimal number system. And apart from these 10 numbers, we have 5 more, that is A, then B, C, D, E and F. Okay. So if you think in terms of the equivalent decimal value from 0 to 9, this same as that of the decimal numbers. Okay. But A represents a decimal digit, decimal value 10, B represents 11, C represents 12, then 13, 14 and 15. Okay. And the radix for this decimal hexadecimal number system is 16. Okay. R is 16 in this case. Okay. Now I will tell you how to convert a binary sequence into hexadecimal sequence. Okay, so what we do, we make a group of 4 digits. Okay, and that 4 digits will be mapped to either of this number from the given numbers here. Okay, for example, take a binary sequence here. Let's say that it is 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 1, then 1 1 0 1. So let's start. We start from the leftmost position, rightmost position, and make a group of 4 digits. Okay. So I have made another group of four digits. This is another group of 4 digits. Okay. Then what we do, we check what is the equivalent decimal value for this sequence 1101. Okay, so you know that 1101 is how much? It is 13, is it? 8 plus 4 plus 1, 13. So 13 here is equivalent to 10, 11, 12, 13. So this is 13. So I will write here D. Okay. Then similarly, we will treat this next group of 4 digits. Here we have 1101. So it is again 13. So the same D will be assigned here. Okay. And then 1010, that means 8 plus 2, 10. 10 means A. So I can write here, this binary sequence is equivalent to a hexadecimal number A, D and D. Okay. And I will write here the base 16 for this hexadecimal number. Okay. So what advantage you notice here, that the long binary stream is represented by few numbers, very small numbers, in this hexadecimal system, that is ADD, only three numbers are actually used here to represent such a long binary string in the hexadecimal system. Okay. So, this is one of the advantages of this hexadecimal system. In fact, in our microprocessor 8085, okay, we give data to microprocessor in this hexadecimal unit. Okay. Instructions and data are given in this form only. Okay. Is it clear to all of you? Okay. Now, let me tell you how to convert this hexadecimal into a digital form. So, that is seems to be very easy. The reverse process of this, okay. The reverse process of this, you can see, let us say that if a hexadecimal number is given here, for example, 7, 0, A and D. So, what we will do? We will represent one each hexadecimal number here by a string of 4 binary numbers. Okay. So, D will be represented here as 1101, then A can be represented by 1010, 1010, 0 will again represented by 4 binary digits because 0 is possible in hexadecimal. Okay. So, 0 is represented by 4 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 7 can be represented as 0, 1, 1 and 1. Okay. This manner you can convert this hexadecimal number into a decimal number, into a binary number. Okay. It is very easy to convert. Okay. Now, we can also try to convert a hexadecimal number into a decimal number. Okay. Hexadecimal into conversion of hexadecimal to decimal is done using that weight equation. Okay. The weight equation I have given you in the previous class, that was n equal to dn r to the power n plus dn minus 1 into r to the power n minus 1 plus d1 r to the power 0 plus d0 r to the power 0. I told you that r is the radix or base for the particular given number system, n is number of digits in that given number. And that n is actually n starts from 0, we count n from 0. Okay. 0 is the least, this d 0 is the least significant bit. Okay. R to the power 0 is the weight of this digit. Similarly, this is r to the power 1. R to the power 1 is the weight of this digit, and r to the power n is the weight of this digit. Okay. So, in hexadecimal number system, R is 16. Okay. So, using this fact that R is 16, we can convert any hexadecimal number into decimal form. Okay. For example, let us say that the given number, hexadecimal number, is same here, 70AD. Okay. So, the least significant bit is D. I mean, the least significant number here is least significant one is D. So, I will write the weight of this 70AD as D into, since base is 16, 16 to the power 0 plus the next one is A into 16 to the power 1 plus 0 into 16 to the power 2 plus 7 into 16 to the power 3. Okay. And to find out the final equivalent decimal number, we will have to replace this D by equivalent decimal number. and similarly a by the equivalent decimal number. Okay, so n can be written as 7 into 16 power 3. 7 is equivalent, even 7 is the same in decimal number system. This is 0 plus a is 10 to the power 10 into 16 plus d is how much? 13 into 1. Okay. So, you can solve this in order to find out the equivalent decimal value for this given hexadecimal sequence 70ADD. Okay. It is very simple. You can use the weight formula for hexadecimal to decimal conversion. Okay. What about the reverse one? What about the decimal to hexadecimal conversion? The decimal to hexadecimal conversion is done in the similar fashion as decimal was number was converted into binary form. Okay. So, let us say that a decimal number is given that is 10, let us say 52. Okay. Let me take another example. The number is let us say that 57345. Okay, generally we neglect, but if you are talking about the multiple number system, the number should come with the base. So, this 57345 base 10 says that this number is a decimal number. Okay. Now, how can I convert this decimal number into hexadecimal form? So, for that I need to divide, keep dividing this number by 16. Okay. And I will note the remainder, okay, and then again keep that quotient divided by the 16 until we reaches a remainder which is a quotient which is smaller than that of the 16. Okay. So, what I will do here, I will first try to divide it by 16. Okay. So, if I divide it by 16, then the quotient comes 3584 with a remainder 1. Okay. In first step, when I divide this number by 16, the quotient is 3584 and the remainder is 1. Okay. Then this number is still larger than 16. So, what I have to do? I will have to divide it again by 16. So, dividing this number by 16 now gives another number that is 224 and the remainder is still 0. The remainder is 0 in this case. Okay. But this again 224 is greater than 16. So, I will again divide this by 16 and what I find the here 14. Quotient is 14 in this case and the difference is remainder is 0. Okay. Now, I notice here that this 14 is smaller than 16. So, I will have to stop here at this point. Okay. 14 as you know can be represented by E. So, this 14 is in hexadecimal it is E. Then I will write to 0, 0 and 1. I will follow this sequence. Okay. That means, this digit is the most significant digit. I mean, this one is most significant number you can say and this one is the least significant one. Okay. Least significant and most significant. Okay. So, now I can arrange that like this 14 is E. So, it is E 0 0 1. Our hexadecimal number at base 16. Okay. Recall we followed the same procedure for decimal to binary conversion. Okay. So, thus we can convert the decimal number into a hexadecimal number. Okay. Then the next number system is the octal number system. Okay. In octal number system, what we have to do? We have to make a group of three numbers, three subsequent numbers. Okay. So, if you make a group of three subsequent numbers, let me start with a binary sequence here. Again, 1 0 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0. Okay. So, from the right, I will make the group of three sequence, we'll make the group of three bits. Okay. So, this is our group number 1, then group number 2 3 and 4. Okay. And then I will assign a number. So, you can see that 0 1 0 is equivalent to 2, this 0 1 1 is equivalent to 3, then 3, then 5. Okay. And you can notice here that since we are making a group of 3 numbers, okay, so there are total 8 possible numbers which can be assigned to a given position in this octal number system. Okay. So, those numbers will be starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. So, each position can be given either 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or 7 depending upon the sequence. Okay. Is it clear? So, there is absolutely this system, the octal system is not different from the hexadecimal system, except here we make a group of 3 digit. Okay. So, since because of 3 digit there are only 8 possible numbers starting from 0 to 7, unlike the hexadecimal case where we had total 16 possible numbers to be assigned at a particular position. Okay. And it is also obvious here the radix for this octal number system should be how much? R? 8. Okay. So, R is 8 here. Possible numbers are 0 to 7. So, using these two facts, I can even now convert a given binary number into octal number, or an octal number can also be converted into binary number very easily. Okay. So, just let me give you one example of octal to binary conversion. So, let us say that I have a number 7612 with base 8, so this is octal number. If I convert this number into binary, then I will use 3 digit binary digit to in place of this one octal number. So, for 2 I will write 010 3 digit, for 1 I will write 001, and for 6 I will write 1 1 0, and for 7 all 1 1 1. Okay. So, this octal number is equivalent to this binary number. Okay. So, binary to octal and octal to binary conversion is very easy, very simple. Okay. And what about decimal to octal conversion? How should we do this? We have to divide by 8 and we just note down the reminders. Okay. We will keep dividing until we reach to a quotient which is smaller than 8. Okay. We'll note all those reminders and make put them into the same sequence as we did before. Okay. The last reminder will be the most significant bit, the first one will be the least significant bit. Okay. Now we will discuss the important concepts of complements. Okay. If you recall that in previous class what we did, we subtract one number from another. Okay. And basically those two numbers were digital numbers, binary numbers. Okay. And what we did, we took the advantage of borrow. Okay. Based on the borrow concept from the next significant position where we had 1, we took a borrow and then we subtracted. Okay. But the computer does not understand this borrow concept. Okay. So, some other concept is used to computer let do this subtraction, and that concept is actually based on this complements. Okay. So, for any number system, we have two complements. If the number system has base R, okay. So, for that number system, we have two complements, one is called RS and the next one is called R minus 1 S. Okay. For example, for decimal number system, R is 10. So, for decimal number system, we will have two complements. The one is 10th complements or 9th complements. Okay. Similarly, for binary number system, since our radix is 2, so for binary number system, we will have two complements. The one is 2's complement and 1's complement for binary system. For decimal system, 10th complement and 9 complements. Okay. Basically, these complements are used to represent a negative number. Okay, that we will discuss in detail later on. Okay. Now, let me tell you how to write an R complements for a given number. R complement. So, let us say that we are given a number n and this number has total n digit, or you can say if it is a binary number, then there are total n digit. Okay. Then its R's complement is defined as R's complement of this number is defined as 2 to the power n minus this capital N. Okay. Please note that this small n is the integers of this number n. Okay. We have to exclude the decimal part of the given number. We have to consider the only integers part. For example, if a number, let us say that a decimal number is given like this, 212.1134. Okay. So, we will consider n to be 3, okay, because we have 3 numbers 1, 2, 3. We are not going to consider the numbers of this decimal part. Okay, we will consider this part only, 2, 1, 2. So, there are 3 numbers only. Okay. Is it clear? Now, the R's complement, let us say for example, the given number is 1, 2, 3. Okay. Sorry, this is not 2 to the power n, this is general formula should be R to the power n minus n. Okay. For binary system, it is 2 to the power n minus n. Okay. For a general system, it is the base or radix to the power n minus n. So, we are going to take a decimal number as an example, let us say that 1, 2, 3. Then for 1, 2, 3, the R complements is going to be, R is in this case 10. So 10 to the power 3 minus this 1, 2, 3. Okay. So 10 to the power 3 means it is 1000 minus 1, 2, 3. So it is 7. Again 7, 8. Okay. So this 877 is 10th complement of this number 1, 2, 3. Okay. Let us say that we have a another decimal number that is that has both integer and decimal parts. So let us say that it is 4872.123. Okay. So how will you get the 10th complement of this given number? The 10th complement is 10 to the power 4 only. Okay, we will not consider this part. 10 to the power 4 minus 4872.123. Okay. So 10 to the power 4 is again 1, 2, 3, 4 minus 4872.123, and that will be equal to 7 7 8 7 2 1 and 5. Okay. So this 5127.877 is 10th complement of this given decimal number 4872.123. Okay. The same procedure can be adopted for even binary number system. Okay. So let us do one example with a binary number. Binary number may be 10101. Okay. So for 10101, the 2's complement, the R's complement is 2's complement in this case. So 2's complement in this case is, 2's complement for this number is 2 to the power 5 minus the same number 10101. Okay. And 2 to the power 5 means 1 after 50, 2, 3, 4, 5 minus 10101. Okay. Do not write the decimal equivalent of 2 to the power 5. Okay. 2 to the power 5 means 32. So, 32 will be represented by a decimal number, binary number 10000. Okay. Is it clear? Now we can simply subtract this number, this number from this number, and can get the 2's complement. Okay. So when I subtract this number from this, you can follow the borrow method, and then here it will be 1, then 1 0 1 0, okay. Is it correct? So this 0 0 1 0 1 1 is the 2's complement for the given binary number 10101. Okay. And similarly, you can do this exercise for a decimal number. If we have 110.1 let us say that 101, then we can do the exercise in the similar fashion. In this case, the 2's complement will be 2 to the power 3, okay, minus this number 110.101, okay, and then 2 to the power 3 is 1 followed by 30 minus 110.101, okay, and that will be equal to the 110.1000. So, this is going to be our 2's complement for the given binary number, okay, for this binary number. Is it clear? So, you see here that you have to subtract one number from the another number, okay. So, either you can follow the same borrow method, okay, or you can also notice here that if you look at the difference, this final difference, I mean the result here, then what you can see, if you compare this number with this number, what you see that after the first one, this number is actually the complement of this one. I mean the each other digits are just flipped here, okay. Just look here, these two numbers, okay, what we have, 1, so 1 is as it is. And after this one, the other bits are just flipped, okay, they are toggled. I mean earlier it was 0, if it was 0, it is written 1, if it was 1, then it is finally written 0, okay. Please notice, 1, 0 becomes 1, then 1 becomes 0, 0 becomes 1, 1 becomes 0, 1, 0. Okay, getting this? So, you can write this 2's complement very smartly. What you have to do? You have to start from the least significant bit, okay. Then check when you are getting the first one, okay. The first one will be written as it is. If it is 0, that least significant bit, write it 0, okay. Then go to the next bit, if it is again 0, write it 0. If it is 1, then that 1 will be written as it is, and the other bits, subsequent bits, will be simply flipped, okay. That means 1 will be replaced by 0, 0 will be replaced by 1, and so on, okay. So, if you remember this, you can write the 2's complement for a binary number, okay. And the same technique can also be used for a decimal number. When you write the 10's complement of a decimal number, then what you do? Subtract the first number, let us say we have a decimal number 4783, okay. If I have to write the 10's complement of this number, you can write this 10's complement of this number, simply what you do? Subtract the first number from the 10 and another numbers from the 9, okay. So, the first number is 3 here. So, let me write 10 minus 3, that is 7, 9 minus 8, 1, 9 minus 7, 2, this 9 minus 4, 5. So, this 5, 2, 1, 7 is 10's complement of this number 4783, okay. You need not to use that equation r to the power n minus the given number, okay. If you recall this point, then you can directly write the 10's complement for a decimal number, and similarly the 2's complement for a binary number, okay. Then let me tell you what is r minus 1's complement, okay. R minus 1's complement is defined as R to the power n minus R to the power minus m minus the number n, okay, where n is the same, the total integer numbers, okay, and m is the total numbers of decimal part, okay. For example, if I have 8 7 3 minus 1 3 4 5, so the n is 3 and m is 5, okay. N is total number in integer part and m is total number in decimal parts, okay. Please compare this with that of R's complement. In R's complement, what we did, we neglected this one, okay. We neglected this second term, there was no R to the power minus m. Here we have to include this part, this decimal part as well, okay, apart from the integer part, okay. And I can use this formula in order to write the 1's complement of any number, okay, sorry, the R minus 1's complement of any number. If I talk about, if I take the example from a decimal number system, then let me take the same number here, okay. For this same number, what will be, for this same number, R is, as you know, 10, okay, m is, n is 3 and m is 5, okay. So let me write here the 1's complement of, the 9th complement of this number, the 9th complement of this decimal number is 10 to the power 3 minus 10 to the power minus 5 minus the number 8 7 3 point 1 2 3 4 5, okay. 10 to the power 3, as you know, is 1000, minus 10 to the power minus 5 is what? 0.00001 at fifth position, okay, 1 at fifth position, minus the same number 8 7 3 point 1 2 3 4 5, okay. Then subtract this from this, what you have? 999.99999 minus 8 7 3 point 1 2 3 4 5, okay. So what you have to do, you have to subtract each number from the 9 in order to get the 9th complement, okay. So here I will have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6, 2, 1. So this 126.87654 is the 9th complement for the decimal number 8 7 3 point 1 2 3 4 5, okay. Is it clear? And similarly, I can have, I can write that 1's complement in binary number system, okay. In 1's complement is very easy to write. In binary system, let us say that I have a number 101011, okay. Is it clear? So, n in this case is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, m is 0. So the 1's complement for this binary number is to be 2 to the power 7, okay, minus 2 to the power 0 minus this given number, that is 10101. Okay. 2 to the power 7 means 1, after 1 there are 7 0, okay. After 1 there are 7 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 minus 1 minus this same number, okay. And what about this difference? It is 6 1, it is 1 7 0 minus 1, that means 6 1, okay. If you have 6 1 add plus 1, what do you get? 1 plus 1 7 0, okay. So this is nothing but 6 1, so 6 1 1 2 3 4 5 6 minus this number 1 0 1 0 1 1 1, okay. So the result in this case is 0 0 0 1 0 1 0, okay. So if you compare this result, 1's complement of this number, what you find? That each and every bits or digits of this number are flipped, simply flipped. You have written the complement of that particular number, okay. That means for 1 you write 0, for 1 you write 0, for 0 you write 1, and for 0 again 1, and for 1 it is 0, okay. So writing 1's complement is very simple. Writing 1's complement in binary number is very simple. Just flip each and every bit of that number. If it is 1, make it 0. If it was 0, make it 1. That will be 1's complement, okay. And from 1's complement, you can further get the 2's complement. If you write 1 in 1's complement, if you add 1 in 1's complement, it becomes 2's complement, okay. Just remember that formula, previous one. It was r to the power n minus, it was r to the power n minus n, and here we have r to the power n minus r to the power minus m minus n, okay. So this is, if the second part is 0, this is simply r to the power 0 1, that means this is 1 less. If you add 1 in this number, it becomes this, r to the power n minus n, okay. So to find out the 2's complement, simply find the 1's complement by complementing each digit and then add 1, it gives you the 2's complement, okay. Is it clear? And one more thing I have forgotten to mention about the R's complement. Basically that formula for R's complement, that is R n minus n, it is valid only if this n is a non-zero number, okay. If n is 0, this formula is not valid. If n is 0, then its 2's complement is simply 0. For n equal to 0, the 2's complement is 0. Okay. Whereas for 0, the 1's complement is 1. Okay. 1 complement can be calculated using this formula, but the 2's complement cannot be. Okay. Now let me show you the use of these complements, 1 and 2's complements. Using 2's complement, I will try to subtract, I will try to do this mathematical operation m minus n, where both m and n are positive number. That means I am going to subtract this n from m, okay. Subtracting n from n is possible by using this 2's complement concept, okay. Using 2's complement make it very simple, okay. Just let me take one example. 2's complement or R's complement, you say, in general. Okay. So what is done to subtract this n from m? Basically, this is a two-step process, subtracting n from m. Okay. In first step, what we do, we write the r's complement of n. Okay. In first step, get the r's complement for this n, and in second step, add this r's complement m plus r's complement of n. Okay. In the next step, what we do? We add this r's complement with this m only. Okay. And then we notice the output, we notice the result. If in the result we have a carry 1, okay, then what we do? We discard that carry. Notice the carry 1. If the carry is 1, if carry is 1, then what we do? Discard the carry. Discard carry. And the remaining numbers are the difference. Okay, write the remaining numbers, that will be the difference. Okay, if the carry is 1. Okay, and if the carry is not 1, then what we do? Then we take the r's complement, take r's complement of the difference of that result, takes r complement of result. Okay, and put the number with minus sign. Okay, so let me repeat these two steps once again. What we do in the first step, we write the r's complement for this second number. Okay. R's complement of the second number, then in next step I add the R's complement with M, I notice the result. Okay. If that result has one carry, that means one extra digit at the leftmost position, then I will remove that carry and write the rest of the result as a difference. Okay. But if there is no carry, then what I do? Then I take the R's complement of the result. Okay. And then I will write that result with a minus sign. Okay, the final R's complement will be written with a minus sign. Okay, so let me take the examples from decimal number system, and then we'll do the same for binary number system. Okay, so the examples are, just let me subtract this two number. The one is 72532, and from 72532 I have to subtract 3250. Okay. This is our m, this one is n. Okay. So let me just follow the borrow method first to have a reference result. Okay. So if I take borrow method, then the difference is 2, 8, 2, 9, 6. This is the difference, 69282, which we are looking for. Okay. Now let's go for this R's complement method. Okay. And see whether we are getting the same result or not. Okay. So in R's complement method, first of all, we will try to have the tens complement for this number. Okay. So what will the tens complement? Now you can directly say the tens complement of this number. The tens complement is 0. then 4, 0 or 4, 5, 5, should be 5, then 7, then 6. Okay, what I told you? I told you that if there is 0, leave that number. Find the first significant, I mean non-zero number. Okay, subtract that from 10 and then the rest number will be subtracted from 9. Okay, you can do this exercise and check whether I am right or wrong. Okay. So, we are trying to write the R's complement of this number n, and the R's complement for this number was 3250. The tens complement for this number was 0, 5, 7, and 6. Okay. Then what I will do? I will add this number here with this number. Okay. So let me add these two numbers, 2, 3, 5, 2 and 7. Okay. Add these two numbers, we get 2, 8, 12, 7, 9 and 7. Okay. Is it okay? Clear to all of you? What we did? We take the two's complement, R's tens complement for this number. That was 6750. Then I add 6750 to this first number m, and I got this. Okay. Then I will have to notice this result. Okay. I will have to check for the carries. What we have? Are we having any carry here? Are we having carry? No carry. Okay, since there is no carry, then what I have to do? I will have to take the 2's complement of this number. Are we making a mistake somewhere? Five, 2, 8, 12, 9, 7. Okay, we will have to check carry here at the rightmost position. Okay, we do not have carry here. So, since we do not have carry, then we will have to take the 2's complement. Okay, I think somewhere some mistake. Let me do this once again. Okay. The two number is R 72532, 72532, and the second one is 03250. We did a mistake, we left this 0 while writing that complement. Okay. So now we will have to write the 2's complement for this number, and the 2's complement for the second number will be 0, 5, 7, 6 and 9. Okay. Then I will write this 2's complement, I will add this 2's complement to this number. Okay. So adding this to this number 72532, this gives us 2829. Okay. Now is it correct? Okay. So now just notice the output, final result. So in final result we have one carry. we have carry, that is 1. Okay, original digit was, original number was of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There were only 5 numbers in this one. But what we have here, we are having 6 numbers. Okay, I mean total 6 digits here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so this 6th one which was carry can be neglected now, and the rest is our difference. Okay. Just you can do the, I mean follow the Barrow method for differencing these 2 numbers, and you can verify whether you are getting the same or not. Okay. You will get the same number. Is it clear? Now, just reverse this. Try to subtract 72532 from this 03250. Okay. Now what I do? I write this number to be M and this number to be N. Okay. Please do this in your copy. So in first step, what I will do? I will write the tens complement of this number N. Okay. And what will be the tens complement in for this number? Please tell me. 8, 6, 4, 7, 2. Okay. The first one is subtracted from 10 and another numbers are subtracted from 9. Okay. So here is the tens complement for this number N. Now what I will do? I will add these 2 numbers. Okay, this M plus the 2's complement of this N. Okay, let me add here, I will get 8, 1, 7, 0, 3. So, it is 3, 0, 7, 1, 8. Is there any carry in this case? No carry. So, no carry means I will have to take the tens complement of this answer once again, and then I will put that number with a negative sign. Is it clear? So let me take the tens complement of this number. What will be the tens complement? Tens complement of this number will be 2, 8, 2, 9, 6 with a minus sign. Okay. So, you see, we have again got this same number 69282, but now with minus sign, because now you are doing subtracting this larger number from this smaller number. Okay? So, this minus sign is natural in this case. Is it clear? Now, you can do the same practice for a binary number.